Another day, another gimbal, the DJI Ronin SC. Do we need another gimbal? Well, first let's take a look at this little brother to the DJI Ronin S. Its biggest difference is that it's smaller, almost half the weight at 2.4 pounds versus the Ronin S, which is 4.7 pounds. Now the payload capacity has been reduced also, now it's max 2 kilograms or 4.4 pounds, whereas the Ronin S is almost double at 8 pounds or 3.6 kilograms. The build quality is almost the same on both gimbals. The Ronin SC does have more plastic parts to keep the weight down, but it still feels surprisingly sturdy. The camera plate has also been shrunk down and simplified. There is just one knob you have to loosen to adjust the camera position to the left, right, or back and forth, which makes balancing faster. Something to keep in mind though is about the small size of this gimbal. You will not be able to use it with a lot of the cameras that are still within the payload capacity, because if you put a bigger lens that makes the setup front heavy, it means that you will have to move the camera so far back that it will cause your camera to bump the back motor. Like I said, the balancing is faster thanks to the simpler design and also thanks to this positioning block. This makes remembering the back and forth position of the camera very easy. Also, DJI now included locks on each of the arms that makes traveling better, but also it allows you to individually adjust the balance of each axis. That's a big plus and something I loved on the Zion Crane 3 Lab. One cool feature they introduced is the active track, which is similar in their drones. You get a phone mount in the back so you can put it on top of your camera, and then using your phone's camera, you can select the object you want to track in the app or by tapping the trigger. It's actually a fun and useful feature for shots where you simply can't, or maybe it's not safe for you to keep on looking at the camera and manually pointing it. Like in this example where I was walking down some really steep stairs. The camera would tilt and pan for me while I was busy just looking at where I was actually stepping. Just to be aware that this feature will not work well when the subject moves really fast, or if, for example, the light or the angle of your subject changes really fast. For normal to slow movements, it will keep your camera pointed in the right direction. Another feature that's neat but kind of useless for me is the Force Mobile. It follows your phone's movements using the gyroscope. It's a feature that many other gimbals already have had for a long time, like the Moza Aircraft gimbal that I reviewed back in 2017. The Mavic Mimic originally introduced this feature, and I think it's a lot more useful on bigger gimbals and camera setups where you're also gonna have a wireless video system so you can monitor your shot. So on the Ronin SC, without a wireless video system, it kinda ends up being a useless gimmick. Now, things that I do like about this gimbal is that it is a lot simpler and also lighter to use, which means for home video or vlogging, it's actually a useful gimbal because you can set it up fast and carry it for a longer time. The battery lasts around 11 hours. Now, the gimbal is just as smooth when running as the DJI Ronin S, but if you balance the camera properly and also adjust the settings accordingly. And when it comes to the features and different modes of the DJI Ronin SC, it's pretty much identical to the Ronin S. So if you guys want, you can check out that review for more info. You get all your typical profiles like follow and pan only, or pan and tilt follow, or the full POV follow, which also will tilt the camera on the roll axis. Plus, you can very easily customize and set up your own profiles using the app. DJI updated their app and it's actually really great, makes adjustments of your settings or setting up your profiles very easy. So if you like the DJI Ronin S, but maybe you wanted something smaller for lighter mirrorless cameras with shorter lenses, then this gimbal is definitely for you. Now if you want any gimbal that is simply smooth but also lighter, then there's already a lot of great options out there. There are also a lot cheaper, such as the Moza Aircraft. In conclusion, there is nothing really wrong with the DJI Ronin SC gimbal, but also nothing that really makes it stand out. The active track feature is fun, but not always accurate, so I don't think I'm gonna be personally using it for paid work. So anyways, there you have it. It's another great gimbal in a world full of gimbals.